Belinda presents this unabridged recording of Fairy Realm, written by Emily Rodda and read by Lucy Bell.
The Water Sprites by Emily Rodda. Jessie fastened her charm bracelet around her wrist and checked her reflection in the mirror. Her green eyes were sparkling. Her golden red hair shone against the rich blue of her new dress. She looked happy and excited, and no wonder. It was a sunny Saturday afternoon, and she was going to a party. Not an ordinary party either, but a party in the magical world of the realm. The charm bracelet jingled softly as Jessie picked up the gold-speckled leaf lying beside her hairbrush. When she'd found the leaf on her desk a couple of days before, she'd thought at first that it was quite ordinary. She thought the breeze had blown it through her open window. She'd never seen a leaf just like it before, but that wasn't surprising. The Garden of Blue Moon, her grandmother's old house in the mountains, was filled with unusual trees and bushes. Though she and her mother had been living with Granny for over a year, Jessie was still discovering plants that were new to her. When she picked up the speckled leaf, she suddenly saw that there was something strange about it. The yellow speckles were in straight lines, set tidily one above the other. Jessie peered at them closely, and then she realized that the speckles were words. The leaf was covered in tiny yellow writing. Jessie smiled as she remembered how astonished and delighted she'd been as she read the leaf's message for the first time. Princess Jessie, the village of Lirilee invites you to Baby Jewel's welcome party on Saturday afternoon. The party begins at 3 o'clock and ends when the birds go to bed. There will be music, dancing, games, and lots of food. Please come. On the other side of the leaf, there was another message in different handwriting. Hope you can come, Jessie. Gif and Maybelle are invited too. Be at my place at 2:30 and we can all go together. Lirilee is my old home village. Everyone is longing to meet you. Love, Patrice. Jessie had been very relieved to read that note. She had no idea where Lirilee was, but with her friends Patrice, the palace housekeeper, Gif, the elf, and Maybelle, the miniature horse, to guide her, she wouldn't get lost. She glanced at the clock on her bedside table and was startled to see that it was after 2 o'clock. Time had flown. If she didn't hurry, she'd be late. She grabbed the gift she'd wrapped in silver paper and hurried out of her room to find her grandmother. Voices were floating from the kitchen. Jessie sighed as she recognised the chirping tones of Mrs. Tweedy, the next-door neighbour. What a nuisance! Mrs. Tweedy was a very curious woman. If she saw Jessie heading for the bottom of the Blue Moon Garden dressed in party clothes, she'd ask all sorts of questions. Jessie hesitated, wondering if she should just slip out the front door without saying goodbye. Her mother was out for the day and Granny would understand. "I'm so upset," Mrs. Tweedy wailed. "I was terribly fond of that ring. It was my mother's." "I'm sure you'll find it, Louise," Granny said soothingly. "It's probably just fallen—" "No," Mrs. Tweedy insisted. "It was on my bedside table in a little crystal dish I remember perfectly. I put it there before I did the washing. I always put it there. That Wiseman person who came to clean the windows took it. I know he did." Jessie's eyes widened, and she felt heat rush into her face. Mr. Wiseman was the father of her friend Sal. He was a kind, cheerful man, always full of jokes and fun, just like Sal. What was Mrs. Tweedy saying about him? She rushed into the kitchen. Granny and Mrs. Tweedy turned to look at her. "Is that a new outfit, dear?" asked Mrs. Tweedy, her sharp little nose twitching as she looked Jessie up and down. "I don't think I've seen it before. It's very pretty. Are you going to a party?"
"Yes," Jessie said breathlessly.
"But, Mrs. Tweedy, I couldn't help hearing what you were saying about Mr. Wiseman just now, and..."
Mrs. Tweedy's face grew solemn.
"It's not very nice, I know," she said. "I hate to accuse anyone, but facts are facts. I can't go to the police. I mean, the man will just deny he took my ring, won't he? But I know he did it, and it's only right to warn people about him."
"Louise, believe me, Alf Wiseman is no thief," Granny said very firmly. "He's been in and out of Blue Moon for years, ever since he started his window cleaning business. He's as honest as the day is long."
"Of course he is," Jessie exclaimed. "He's my friend's dad. I know him really well."
Mrs. Tweedy looked at her sorrowfully.
"I am sorry, dear," she said, "but sadly people aren't always what they seem."
"Jessie, you'd better go or you'll be late," Granny said, as Jessie opened her mouth to argue. "You'll have to run as it is."
"Don't tell me you're walking to the party, dear," cried Mrs. Tweedy as Jessie hurried to the door. "In your nice dress and shoes? No, no, come on, I'll drive you."
"No," Jessie exclaimed, horrified.
"I mean, thank you, but it isn't far. I don't need a lift."
"It's no trouble," said Mrs. Tweedy.
"I must go anyway. I just popped in for a minute to see if your grandmother wanted anything at the supermarket."
And to spread rumours about Mr. Wiseman, Jessie thought furiously. But the anger was driven from her mind as Mrs. Tweedy picked up her handbag and car keys from the kitchen table and bustled to join her at the door.
"Now, where's this party? Which street?" Mrs. Tweedy asked brightly.
Panic-stricken, Jessie glanced at her grandmother.
"What a shame you have to go so soon, Louise," Granny said calmly. "I thought you might like to see Robert's studio today. But if you don't have time..."
Mrs. Tweedy's eyebrows shot up. For months she'd been hinting that she wanted to see where Jessie's grandfather, Robert Bellairs, had painted the fairy pictures that had made him famous.
"Oh!" she exclaimed, glancing from Granny to Jessie. "Well, I..."
"You stay, Mrs. Tweedy," Jessie said rapidly. "I'll be fine, really. Bye, Granny."
"And thanks," she added silently as she closed the door behind her. She darted into the shade of the trees behind the house and began running towards the tall, clipped hedge at the bottom of the garden. "Seeing Grandpa's studio will put Mrs. Tweedy in a good mood," she thought as she ran. "Maybe then Granny will be able to convince her that Mr. Wiseman couldn't have stolen her ring. Oh, I hope so." She could just imagine Mrs. Tweedy twittering over the paintings stacked against the studio walls.
"Oh, they're really marvellous," Mrs. Tweedy would be saying to Granny, as if Granny didn't know. "So magical, yet so lifelike. You'd swear he'd really seen the things he painted."
"Yes, people often say that," Granny would agree mildly, and she'd listen with a smile while Mrs. Tweedy went on and on. Because only Jessie shared Granny's secret. Only Jessie and Granny knew that Robert Bellairs really had seen the things he'd painted. He'd seen them in the magical world of the realm. And in the realm, he'd fallen in love with Jessica, a beautiful fairy princess with golden red hair. Princess Jessica had been born to be the realm's true queen, but she'd run away with Robert to the mortal world, to Blue Moon, to become his wife. Over 50 years had passed since then. The blue dress Granny had worn on the night she'd left the realm had faded to soft grey in the carved chest in her bedroom. Her golden red hair had turned white, but her eyes were still as green as they had ever been, and her smile was just as sweet. Granny rarely returned to the realm. She said that going back too often was unfair to her sister Helena, who now ruled the realm in her place. She said she was content with the life and the world she'd chosen. But when Jessie had shown her the party invitation on the day it arrived, she'd sighed. Lirily, she'd said softly. Oh, I used to go there often with Patrice long ago. It's in the hills beside the stream that runs down to the finding pool. The finding pool? What's that? Jessie had asked, fascinated. The most beautiful place. You'll see, Granny had smiled, her eyes filled with memories. It was there that your grandfather and I met for the first time. Afterwards, we visited it together often. Oh, I'd love to see it again. I haven't seen the finding pool since the night we left the realm.
Then come with me to the party, Granny, Jessie had urged. You can visit the finding pool again on the way, and everyone in Lirilee will be so pleased to see you.
But Granny had shaken her head. Just send them my love, she'd said, and when you get back, tell me all about it. Jessie reached the hedge and hurried into the place she called the secret garden. The warm air was filled with the scent of the rosemary bushes that surrounded the little square of smooth green grass. Open, Jessie whispered and closed her eyes.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.